So I heard y'all loud and clear in my Samus video when you guys said you wanted me to talk about King K. Rool. And thankfully, before I recorded this, some footage was released of a one-on-one of King K. Rool versus Snake, so we can actually talk about him more in depth as opposed to just speculation. Honestly, when he was first announced, I was like, okay, cool, another heavy that's gonna be mediocre. In my head, he didn't really have a lot of throw combos, which I don't think is still really a thing, and he just seemed like another kind of mediocre heavy, I'm gonna get juggled type of character. But the more I watched that video, the more I'm just really, honestly, kind of impressed with the character. I think he is going to be playable, as a quick little recap of what I think. I think the character's gonna be pretty good. So let's just talk about the footage real quick. First off, the most notable thing, in my opinion, isn't even the crazy kill that everyone talks about, but I'll get to that later, is his crown. That projectile is so cool. It covers so many options. It helps tech chasing, it helps option coverage, it just does so many things, and then it becomes an item on the floor that you can then use in multiple different angles, at the very least, the main four. That's such an interesting option, because you typically don't have something that boomerangs back to you, other than, again, Link and Toon Link boomerang, which honestly were kind of mediocre. I like the slower crown throw. I like that type. It's just, it's interesting because you're gonna be able to knock someone down, throw the crown to cover multiple options, and then maybe like run to cover a different option, or okay, cool, I didn't cover tech away, time to just take all the space, because everything else is a free punish, because if they tech in, you can hit them. If they tech neutral, the crown will hit them. If they tech in, you can have, again, more pressure, or maybe even some new combos with like a light tap into the crown, into like an up smash or something. There are so many possibilities for this character. Surprisingly trap based, it seems like the cannonball goes through other projectiles, which seems amazing, because you can fight zoners with the cannonball, and then obviously if it gets hit back to you, you can pull it back in and then shoot it for massive damage. And as I mentioned, I want to talk about that kill he got on the snake, where he shot the cannon and then forward aired snake into it. But it's really cool because you can shoot the gun at multiple angles on the second one, it seems like. I don't know about the first one, again, there's not enough footage to really know that, but it seems like you can shoot it at the very least forward, and then the diagonal above you, and then probably the diagonal below you, which would be amazing for edgeguarding if you're able to just like shoot it, pull it back, shoot it down, because it'll cover that. You know, people have to recover high because they don't want to recover just out, because you're going to be able to hit him with the weaker cannonball as opposed to the second shot, which seems stronger, at least at the current moment. His damage output is actually ridiculous. You have a 16% up throw that is obviously like a Kirby up throw, so you get out of the way of certain projectiles, like you saw it get out of the way of Snake's Nikita. He just seems really cool. He has the body splash nair like King Day-to-Day, which I honestly am a huge fan of. I love that nair. When I play Day-to-Day, that's pretty much all I do when I'm landing, is just that. You know, I don't know all of his landing options, but his back air and his forward air seem pretty safe, or at least pretty just like good to come down with a move, and then his nair, obviously, you're gonna have to respect it. So this character honestly looks very, very interesting. You know, I'm really glad they didn't give him a stall and fall down air. Think of like Zero Suit Sheik or things like that, where a lot of characters like stop in the air and then fall, and you know, Bowser has that, and that's the heavy that I normally play, so I'm really glad they gave him a more normal down air, so we can finally like down air and drift away, or like forward air and drift away. You're gonna have to cover so many different ranges. I still think he will be kind of easy to juggle. He is still a big body, and you know, his nair is good, and his down air, his aerial seem good, but I feel like any disjointed aerial, like a Marth up air or something like that, will just be able to keep him in the air fairly easily. But again, he's heavy, he can take hits. If we still use rage, if that toggle is a thing, which I guess I can talk about in a different video with the rage toggle thing once we get more information on that, you know, he's gonna be able to kill really early, and it already looks like he can kill so early with that cannonball. It is just, oh, he's fun, and I'm honestly like, I hate to go back to it, but the crown is so cool. Honestly, like, I love that type of thing where you can just cover multiple areas. As you know, it reminds me a lot of what I do in Advantage when, like, I hit someone, I will shoot Thunder Jolt at, like, different areas and cover multiple options. It reminds me a lot of that. So, honestly, I might try King K. Rool. He seems like a lot of fun, and I honestly do kind of want to take him at least a little bit seriously. Like, probably not, again, one of my mains unless he ends up being really, really good. But I'm honestly interested in playing him. That crown opens up so many possibilities. He's just going to hit so hard. He's going to deal so much damage. His back air does like 20 for some reason. I have no idea why. But oh man, that character is, it's just honestly, that gameplay gave me so much more faith in him, because honestly, I was like a lot of people where I saw him and I was like, oh, he's gonna be okay. Like, he's just another big body. He's gonna get bodied by, you know, so many juggle characters. And again, that might be the case, but he's fast. Again, like the new age of heavies where he's so, so fast. I think he's heavier at least than when I played, it seemed like when I played Bowser at the E3 Invitational. So again, he's fast, he's strong. It seems like his up is gonna be a little bit harder to edgeguard than some characters. I don't know if it has a hitbox on it where the propeller is, but either way, he's gonna be a little bit more mobile, I feel like, than Bowser and DK, which are the two heavies you really think of. I mean, obviously Day-to-Day has a really good recovery with the multiple jumps and his super armor uppy, but I just, I don't know, I'm so excited for King K. Rool. He's, again, he's fast, He's strong. He has a lot of cool little setups. He has so much option coverage with that crown. God, I'm so excited for the crown. And I mean, yeah, honestly, like, what other characters you guys want me to talk about? Because I might talk about the Belmonts. I think I'm actually going to do a video about that, so don't worry about commenting. But if you want to know any other information about this game or anything you want me to explain that has been covered, please let me know, and I'll see you all next time. Bye.